Now that you have spent some time as a student, we will take a look at the instructor side. I will provide an overview of three different reports that ALEKS provides, which gives you an in-depth look at your students and their performance in the class. The first of these is the ALEKS Pie Report. This report provides a view of what your students have mastered, not mastered, and are ready to learn. It provides a snapshot of where your class is at a glance. The ALEKS Pie Report can be accessed from the instructor dashboard. The tile on the dashboard called ALEKS Pie Report displays the average number of topics your students have completed, along with the corresponding percentage of pie completed. Hovering over a pie slice in the ALEKS Pie Report tile provides the average number of topics mastered, learned, and remaining in a particular slice. Viewing the full pie report displays a list of topics from the entire pie that are ready to learn by the largest percentage of students. Scrolling to the bottom of the pie report gives details on each topic by the objective that you've assigned. Expanding a particular objective gives a list of topics in that section, along with a percentage of students who have added that topic to their pie, called progress, the percentage of students who still have that topic to learn, remaining, the percentage of students who are ready to learn the topic. Remember, that means that a student is 92% likely to have success with that topic. And then also the percentage of students who have attempted but not yet learned the topic. Clicking on a particular percentage gives a list of students who are in those particular categories. Each of the columns can be sorted. Clicking a particular topic will give you an example of that type of problem. This report is the most beneficial to me in gauging what I do in class. If the class is covering a certain objective, then before the class meets, I can look at this pie report and determine if a majority of the students have already learned this topic, how many of the students are ready to learn. Typically, I use about a 30% mark as where I will introduce a topic in class. If I have topics that are below that, I might delay that activity, or I might realize that, well, once I teach this topic, then that topic is going to be more accessible for students, so I can stagger my lessons according to the ready-to-learn percentage. Students benefit from seeing a lesson on the topics that are more complex or more conceptual. The next report I want to share with you is the ALEKS Progress Report. This report enables you to visualize a student's progress over time. The Progress Report can be accessed from the Reports menu and then clicking Progress. This report provides each student's overall progress in the course in five different views. Learning progress since latest knowledge check, most recent knowledge check, best performance in learning mode over time, progress in knowledge check over time, and detailed progress history. I prefer the detailed progress history. Here's a student that shows that they knew 6% of the course content when the class started. After that initial knowledge check, the student learned an additional 10% of the course content. So they were up to 16%. When they went to the next knowledge check, that automatic knowledge check, they maintained that 16% of the content. Then they added 10% to it. So they were up to 26%. Then another knowledge check showed that they retained 26% of the topics, then added 10% more. Then the next knowledge check actually showed that they increased in the number of topics that they knew. And so you can see the continued growth. The dark blue shows where they started from the knowledge check. The light blue is how much they added since that knowledge check. So you should see that bar filling in as we go through the semester. Also on this report, you can see the average learning rate for a student. This is good because if we see a student is spending a lot of time in ALEKS, but they're not getting through a lot of topics, and that's how we know we need to intervene with that student and ask how they are spending their time when they're actually working in ALEKS. The last of the reports that I want to share with you is the Time and Topic Report. This is a very powerful tool in ALEKS. It enables you to view the specific actions of your students as they work through the learning mode. It gives you a detailed report on the time in ALEKS, the topics attempted, the topics mastered for a selected day, or over a specified period of time. The Time and Topic Report can be accessed from the Instructor Dashboard in ALEKS. There's a Time and Topic tile, or also the Reports menu. When hovering over the Time and Topic tile, you can view the hours, topics attempted, and topics mastered in the course for a selected day, over a 1 week period, a 2 week period, 1 month period, or even 3 month period. The full Time and Topic Report view displays a line graph of the total time spent in ALEKS for each day within a selected date range. Rolling the mouse over the graph gives the exact number of minutes in ALEKS for a given day. The display can be changed to show the average time, total topics, and average topics. Scrolling down further, we see a daily breakdown of how each student spends his or her time in ALEKS. Clicking a specific student takes you to this student's learning sequence log. Hovering over the bar graph shows you the time the student spent that day working in ALEKS, how many topics they learned, how many they attempted and didn't learn. If we actually click it, we can drill down to even more specific information about the student. We can see every click and problem that they worked correctly or incorrectly. We see a sequence of check marks, X marks, and explain icons. If we click one of these icons, we can see the specific problem that the student worked. We can see the answer that the student entered along with the correct answer. Whenever I'm teaching a class in ALEKS, I pull up a sample learning sequence log to show students that I have access to this information. I want them to know that if all they do is click explain, work a problem, click explain, work a problem, they're giving themselves an illusion of competence and that they need to spend time where they're actually struggling with the content and learning it for themselves. I point out that getting X marks is not problematic, right? We want students to struggle with the material so that it becomes their own information that they can retain and use later on. I want to go back to the class level view for just a moment. I can see the average time spent per day in ALEKS by my class, and I pull this up in class often to show students where they are in relation to other classmates. I think it's important to let them see if they're either lagging behind or if they're ahead of the game. This is a good tool to change student behavior. Sometimes seeing what other people are doing makes a student realize that they're not pulling their weight in the class. I hope these reports have shown you how the ALEKS data and intelligence provides us as instructors with more control with our students because we really know what they're doing and we know the pace that they're working. We have control over what they really need when they need it. This is unlike any other system that I've experienced. Typically, I see the problems that they worked, but I don't really see how many times a student had to click explain or help me solve this to get the answer to the problem. I know that schools don't often have the resources or the space to have all of their math classes in computer labs. So even though you may not have dedicated lab time for your classes where ALEKS may be used, that's okay. Students are working in the system, which will give you the information you need about their progress and how to tailor your classes to meet the needs of your students. I would have to say that students love ALEKS. They always ask me if they can use ALEKS in courses higher than the one where we use it, because they know that it's filling in the gaps for them, it's setting them up to succeed, and it holds them accountable to retain the information so that they can move on successfully. Thank you so much for the work and the time that you've dedicated to this student experience. We look forward to hearing from you about this experience and any questions you may have.